Good morning, guys. Working from the home office today, and I got a really, really big announcement to make, and this literally just came in, so I didn't have time to do my hair or even put on proper clothes. I'm wearing just my straight up pajamas because I have to get this out. So over the last year or two, you saw us develop Joonbi matcha from the ground up, right? Like we're at Smorgasbord. It was just a food and drink truck. Then we had one location and we opened two locations. So now we have two physical locations in LA. And then every time we do meet and greets there, or every time we talk about it on our social media, people are always like, please bring it to our city. Come to Houston, come to New York, come to London, come to Spain. And we're like, oh man, we would love to bring Joonbi everywhere to people that want it and want to enjoy high-end matcha with delicious variations and drinks, but it's hard to do it on our own, which is why we want to open up franchising opportunities so we can partner up with people in those cities to bring Joonbi out there quicker, faster, and people know the local environment and neighborhood way better so we can custom suit it to each one of those environments' needs. And we're actually gonna put it off because of what's going on right now, right? Like the entire economy is slowing down and everything. And so we started doing our own market research and we're like, wait a second, 7-Eleven and Subway opened 5,000 to 6,000 stores each during the last recession, which is in 2008 and 2010. And we're like, how is that even possible? So what we found is that during a recession, the real estate prices are way cheaper than normal. And because of that, there's way more real estate that is available. And so the landlords are much more willing to work out a deal with you guys. So if you guys have ever opened up a business, you guys know whether it's the lease, the mortgage, the rent, whatever, like real estate is the biggest expense. And then comes the construction, right? And with a landlord being able to work with you, a lot of times they'll offer help in construction because they know that by then helping you with these tenant improvements, it's gonna bring value to their space. They're gonna work out better terms. So, in terms of for those of you guys who are wanting to franchise, the ball's in your court and you are the best prepared you're ever gonna be during a recession. So, for us, we're like, you know what? We want all of our partners to be the best suited for this. Because your guys' success is our success. So let's launch it now. So if you guys are extremely interested in being a partner, joining our Joonbi family, and doing businesses with us, make sure you go to Joonbi's site. The link is below. There's a franchise questionnaire that you'll fill out so we can get to know you. You guys can get to know us. And hopefully we can get this whole party started. And for those of you guys that are like, man, I ain't trying to franchise, dude. I just want to drink. Guess what? Go to the same exact link below and click and vote for the next city you want us to come to. Because while we're building out these franchises, we also will be building out our own stores. And so helping us know where to go to next will help bring us the Joonbi to you guys faster and closer. And we do want to make Joonbi available to everyone. Like, that's our goal. So please go to the link below, both if you're interested in franchising or if you just want some good ass matcha, some boba, some snacks in your hood. Let us know in the description below and click that link. My cheap squat rack that I just ordered on Amazon finally came in after 2 weeks of delays, which is completely understandable given what's going on right now, but my legs have been begging for them. I've been wanting to squat heavier, and I have the weights at home, I just don't have the squat rack. So it just came in. I'm about to build this right now. And I have my little helper who is just out there throwing a lid. Hey, pick that up, that's littering. Go get it. Thank you. And he even brought his little tools, which is awesome. He has his hammer, his pliers, his measuring tape. Oh, safety first. Good job, Taika. You wanna help me build the squat rack? Okay. Come on, you gotta give me the lid, okay? Uh-oh, your goggles. You gotta get, bring your goggles. Get your goggles. No, leave it. Leave that there. Put it back. Put it back, thank you. Thank you. Okay, get your goggles. Okay, thank you. One thing I like to do before I build anything is get all the tools necessary to make the job easier. So just like IKEA, a lot of stuff you buy on Amazon that's kind of like the cheap version of stuff, it'll come with its own tools, but it will take forever to build if you use those things. So for example, every single one of these guys is requiring an Allen key, right? So we all know if we have to crank with this forever, it's gonna take a long time if I'm trying to build a whole rack. So I already found the little, hey, you don't swing, you're gonna smash the car. One thing I already found is this little Allen key thing to go into the drill. So now I can go like that, and it'll be way faster. And also, I already found the nut that I need. And instead of using one of these guys, which will take forever to crank, I found the socket wrench. Honestly, I don't even know if these are the proper terms, but this goes in here perfectly so that I can start cranking on things and it'll be way faster. So that's what I like to do. The only hard part is this little munchkin is stealing all my tools. And no hammer. You can't play with hammer. You can play with anything else but the hammer. Fine, I'll take the hammer. It's too cute. Just don't bang mama's car because I'm gonna get in trouble. Isn't that weird? For some reason, if he bangs mama's car, why do I get in trouble? Shouldn't he get in trouble? Oh, that's a big one. Damn, you're strong, dude. What about yours? Use your tools. Alright, what I'm gonna do, I think the smartest thing to do is move my little toolbox so he can't be taking everything out, because it's gonna be a pain in the ass if I start losing all my tools. Oh, it's so heavy. Yeah, it's too heavy. Okay, you ready to start helping Papa build?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome.
Here's another good tip with or without kids. If you have one of those assembly packs that has a ton of stuff, I like to put it in a bucket. So sometimes things will fall out and I'll start rolling around, right? Especially when like one side is longer than the other. You know how it rolls like that? So it's easy for things to get lost under a tire or some random crevice. So I like to put things in a bucket. So as you're working, if it falls out, you collect it all in one place. And this helps out with this freaking monster. Because for sure he's gonna be playing with everything. Oh, you're fixing the tire?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thanks for fixing the tire. It's gonna be a wild one. So I was starting to build this, and I just had the most genius idea. Literally everything that I'm taking out of here, he puts it back in. And when I move a tool somewhere, he puts it somewhere else. So I read through the entire directions, and I think I'd be able to finish in probably like an hour by myself with him here and him banging the hammer on his face. Are you okay?
Yeah.
You okay? Oh, be careful, okay? I think it'll take me 4 hours. So I was like, yeah, it is dangerous. You gotta be careful. So I was like, wait a second. The guy that subcontracted to install my basketball court is actually local. And I'm like, and he assembles things. And I'm like, what if I just get him? So he is down to come here and assemble it for a super low cost. And we can still stay quarantined and socially distant. I'm just gonna go inside, close the garage door. He can come and assemble it for under $100. And I don't have to worry about this guy, and I can focus on cleaning the rest of the house. I think it might be worth it to multitask, so that's what I'm gonna do. Because I thought we were gonna have a really good time, him bringing out all these fun tools and stuff. Except he wants to play with the real ones, and he's banging himself on the face. So, I think that's the best call to make. Oh my god. Are you fixing the tire with your hammer? Good job. Oh, yeah, yeah, you gotta drill the tire down. Good job. I asked Tyke what he wanted to do in the meantime, and he was like, eat a chocolate bar. So that's what he's doing. He's eating a protein bar. And what I'm gonna do in the time that we save from someone else building the squat rack that I think he could actually help me and I'm not worried, is get Fawn a bath. She's kind of stinky, hasn't gotten a bath in a minute, and I think this would be a cool way to multitask and what I call double dick dildo, because both pussies are getting fucked. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Aw, you're so thoughtful. Then we'll give, you want to give Fawn a bath after you eat your snack? Okay. You don't like giving Fawnie a bath? Yeah, let's give Fawn a bath after you eat a snack, okay?
Not to you. No.
No, we're going to give Fawn a bath. Fawn needs a bath. Okay? Just like you need a bath, Fawn needs a bath. Okay? Okay, we'll give Fawn a bath.
No.
We'll give Fawn a bath. Tekka, help me. Hold the hose.
Yeah!
You got a wet Fawn, okay? She's already wet a little bit, but just keep holding. Hold the tip. Hold the tip right here. No, right here. Right here. Hold it. Okay, now go over there, wet Fawn. Go. You got a wetter. Good job, Fawnie. Good job, Tekka. There we go. Good job. Keep wetting her on the top. On the top right here. She needs to get wet everywhere. Good job. There you go. Yeah, and then now we gotta. No, you gotta put it on top. Put it on top of her. On top of her, you're wetting the ground. On top of Fawn. There you go. You gotta get the dog wet. Good job, Tekka. Good job, Fawnie. Yeah. Yeah, so you gotta keep going to make sure she gets wet everywhere. No, we gotta rub it in. Make sure it gets wet everywhere. Good job. Yeah, she's gonna shake. That's what dogs do. And then you're gonna get water on you, but it's okay. Good job, Tekka. Okay, yeah, that side. Now you gotta do the other side. Good job. Okay, yeah, put more shampoo on her. Good job. Now go like this. Scrub her. Just get scrubbed like this. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Good job, Tekka. Keep scrubbing. Rub it in. She's gonna do it. That's what dogs do. Scrub like that. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Just like how you get dirty. We gotta scrub you. Gotta scrub, scrub funny. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Come on, scrubber. You can do it, Tekka. You gotta scrub her. Scrub, scrub, scrub. There you go. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Good job. Good job, mister. Okay, now keep scrubbing her. You don't need to scrub your own hands. Good job. You're a professional. Yeah. You gotta scrub her little Dragon Ball hair.
Okay,
what's the next step, Tekka?
Dry
her, right?
Yeah.
Awesome, go. Bring her to the towel. Good job. Good job. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Slippery. Careful, okay? Good job. There you go. You want to put the towel on the dog, not on the floor, okay? Because you're going to dry the floor. We don't need the floor to be dry. We need the dog to be dry. Yeah, and you start going like this, just like what we do to you. Good job. Good job, Tekka.
Me.
See how hard it is to dry when she's moving around? Just like how when you move around? Well, you don't shake, though. Thank goodness. All right, we got Fawnie all nice and clean now. Look at you, Fawnie. You're all fluffy with your little fluffy pants. So I just got her out here, just drying. In the shade still, because for some reason, the paws are just really hard to dry out. I think it's because they got those web paws, so there's extra fur. And so no matter how much I use the blower or the towel, they're still really wet, and it damages the floor. So I'm gonna just keep her out here for a little bit. But she looks so fluffy and clean. And now we just gotta clean her bed. Because her bed is stinky. Woo-hoo! The squat rack is done. I love that. In the same amount of time, in 1 hour, when it would have taken me 4 hours to do this, another an hour to wash the dog, would have been 5 hours, and 1 hour, both things are done. Oh, I can finally do pull-ups at home now. That's so cool. The only thing that kind of sucks is my driveway is slanted. So I'll be squatting kind of slanted. And I mean, I could have it facing like this way, but then it takes up more room. I don't know. I don't know what to do. Because I would prefer not to have it all slanted, but I also have to keep in mind, and all of you guys have to keep in mind, everyone in the world has to keep in mind that everything we're doing right now is temporary, you know? Like, it just feels like it sucks, or everyone's going into this panic mode like crazy, but it's not gonna be temporary, and we're all gonna go back to our normal life. So I do see people dropping thousands on home gyms. I'm like, dude, bad move, dude. Remember, this is temporary. Like, I could have brought home like half of the stuff at the gym, but I'm like, this is temporary. So I just need a quick makeshift thing and I'm gonna go right back to the gym. But people are dropping thousands. They're gonna realize when all their other homies are back at the gym, like, oh, I miss all my homies. And then they're like, oh, but I dropped thousands. on this home equipment. What am I gonna do with it? So everything you guys do, remember, one saying or one phrase that I heard a long time ago that I love, don't find permanent solutions. What? Are you gonna go on that polar bar? Okay. Okay, but before things get crazy, I wanna drop you guys with this piece of knowledge that really benefited me. Don't find permanent solutions to temporary problems. Remember that. Permanent solutions to temporary problems? No. Temporary solutions to temporary problems. So when you get all emotional and things are crazy, you go, I wanna break up! I wanna divorce! Think it through. You don't need permanent solutions to temporary problems. And it's all temporary, dude. We're gonna be out of here in no time. So we're trying to get this fool to eat his dumplings, right? And then he started pretending like he was tired. Like he really needed to go to sleep. So I don't know if he's really sleeping or he's just trying to get out of eating. So I'm gonna try to do the ultimate test. Hey babe, you want some ice cream? I saw an eye open up.
Yeah, I think he is pretty tired. Just leave him alone.
Hey babe, you want ice cream or no?
No, just leave him alone. I really want him to sleep. This is around his nap time anyway.
Fine, you passed the test. That was the FBI initiation, and you passed. On to the next level.
I just wish he could sleep on the couch. Should I move him?
Yeah, you're gonna move him to the couch? Or maybe after he's a little bit more tired, because I feel like because he's too early, the minute you move him to the couch, it's gonna be party time. You're gonna take a gamble?
Yeah.
Uh-oh, all right, we're about to witness either World War III or World Peace. Up to you guys, but the hands are in Gio's hands.
The world is in my hands, or the hands are in my hands?
I don't know, but it's either World War III or it's gonna be World Peace. So far, so good. Damn, you're brave. I would not mess with a sleeping baby. I would just leave him alone. So far, so good.
I'm good at Jenga, baby.
It is Jenga, baby. Jenga Taika edition. Don't let him fall. You're ballsy. I would have never messed with this situation.
Let's turn the TV on. Get some ambiance.
Yes, we gotta turn the TV just a little bit. So if there's any sudden noises like fawn barking or a neighbor outside, or you know when the bus goes, it like kind of mellows it out. So
that's why we invest in a sound, a white noisemaker.
Yeah, that's why we have the white noisemaker, so it can keep his ass resting. He set up his little sleep system. What's that? Oh yeah, I made rice. I'm trying to prep for dinner, you know? That's how you can get ahead. When you're making lunch, make dinner. That's racist. It's actually the Corona anthem, so.
Stupid, that's not even funny.
You're the one that brought it to the race.
You're the one that tied Corona.
I didn't tie anything to Corona. I didn't even say which country Corona came from. I just said that that's the Corona song. And you called it the Chinese anthem. Well, we clearly know the rice cooker's from Japan. Damn, so far so good. You are... Like you belong on the cast of Ocean's 11, how smooth you are. told her. Now this fool's making all kinds of demands.